this is not the original intro to this video. I ran into some problems here as I was finishing things up, which left me with a couple choices. To either make a fairly significant overhaul to the video, or record this new intro to tell you guys what happened. Obviously, I chose the latter of the two, so here we go. As you're about to see shortly, after releasing my 7800 XT VR performance video, I ran into an issue with the encode bitrate when using AirLink, which made the graphics look really bad. This problem did not manifest itself while I was working on the 7800 XT video, but seemingly appeared out of nowhere after the video's release. Well, I spent the better part of a week trying to figure out what was wrong and if there was a way to fix it. To make a long story short, I ended up finding a workaround, which became one of the primary subjects of this video. So after getting the script written and recording the vast majority of the footage, I went to record some clips showing the bitrate problem. And you'll never guess what happened. Yeah, the problem is gone. The bitrate is fine again. I seriously debated just cutting the portion out where I talked about the bitrate, but then I had this thought. What if the issue comes back? Or what if this information can help someone in some way? It was then I decided to forge ahead and just let you guys know what happened. I left the video the way I originally wrote it, but there are some sections where I talk about and show the bitrate being bad. In these particular clips, since the bitrate issue I had is no longer present, I had to use the Oculus Debug Tool to do my best recreation of the bitrate problem to give you guys an idea of what I had been dealing with, and what may return in the future, who knows. Anyway, just know those clips are imitations of the problem, and not actual footage of the problem I had. As for the rest of the information in this video, it's all still relevant. You'll learn how to improve your PC VR graphics by increasing the encode resolution, and how to deal with what I call the Radeon 7000 right eye squeezing phenomenon. Okay, that's it. I've talked long enough. Now, here's the video. In my previous video where I tested the VR performance of the 7800 XT, I said this. For all the benchmarks, I used a Quest 2 connected to my PC with a link cable. But to cover all the bases, I did try the 7800 XT with AirLink, and that worked fantastic as well. I don't know what happened between the time I tested the 7800 XT with AirLink and now, but literally the day my review video went live, I fired up the 7800 XT to play some games, and AirLink performance was terrible. The encode resolution was really low, and the encode bitrate was complete trash, which made PC VR with the 7800 XT look like a blurry, muddy mess. Between the time I did my AirLink test for the 7800 XT review and now, there have been updates to both the Oculus PC app and the firmware on the Quest 2, so I don't know if one of those updates broke it, or if I just got lucky and things worked abnormally well the day I was testing AirLink. Either way, we're not about to put up with disgusting looking graphics, so here's what I did. In the Oculus Debug Tool, I first set Link Sharpening to Normal, then set the Encode Resolution Width to 3680. This increased our Encode Resolution Width the 7800 XT from Meta's default of 2016x1056 to 3680x1952, which made things look quite a bit sharper, so long as the streaming bitrate didn't take a dump. The problem is, the bitrate was extremely erratic and was oftentimes lower than 50 megabits per second. So to try and fix this, I set the dynamic bitrate offset to 50 and the dynamic bitrate max to 150. When you do this, the bitrate settings will take effect immediately, but for the encode resolution to change, you'll need to go to the settings in the Oculus app, then the beta tab, and from there restart Oculus. With just those few changes made, the graphics look much better. So if you have an AMD GPU and AirLink looks like complete garbage, give these settings a try and see if they make a difference for you. While this did improve visuals dramatically, I should say performance wasn't completely flawless. Now, don't get the wrong idea, performance wasn't terrible, it just wasn't 100% flawless. I experienced some occasional hitching, but it was infrequent and mild enough that it didn't ruin the experience and I was able to have an enjoyable time playing games. For anyone who doesn't know how to get to the Oculus Debug Tool to input these settings, first open Windows Explorer. go to your C drive, program files, Oculus, support, Oculus diagnostics, and it's right here. Just double click it to launch the tool, and then you can change the settings just like I showed. Another important setting you're gonna wanna make sure of when doing this is that the Oculus runtime is set as the default OpenXR runtime in the Oculus app. There was a few times I didn't pay attention and it was set to SteamVR, and I tried running some of my Oculus games and performance was horrible. Once I switched the runtime to Oculus, things were much better. As always, to get the best performance with AirLink, there are requirements your setup needs to meet and settings on your router you're going to want to enable. I'm not going to get into all of that in this video because I already have a video going over all of that stuff, which you can check out right up here and at the link in the video description. Knowing Radeon GPUs have a history of problems with VR, I tried AirLink with the RX 7600, 7700 XT, and 7900 XTX 2, and they all exhibited the same behavior as the 7800 XT. Low encode resolution and an erratic bitrate. I then tried the same Oculus Debug Tool settings with each of them, and it greatly improved the visuals, and gameplay was acceptable, very much like it was on the 7800 XT. I then threw the three Radeon 6000 GPUs I have on to see what AirLink was like with them. Somewhat surprising to me is I found the default encode resolution with the 6650 XT, 6700 XT, and 6950 XT was 2880 by 1536, which looked noticeably better than Meta's default on the Radeon 7000 GPUs. But even though the encode resolution was higher with the 6000 series GPUs, the bitrate was just as erratic as it was with the 7000 series. So I used the same Oculus Debug Tool settings with them as I did on the 7000 series, and again got much improved visuals and good, but not excellent gameplay. As far as I can tell, this encode resolution and bitrate issue is due to how Meta is choosing to utilize, or rather not utilize, Radeon GPUs when encoding the video stream for AirLink. These problems do not exist with Nvidia GPUs, so it appears Meta is favoring Nvidia when it comes to PC VR with their headsets. When using a link cable with a Radeon GPU, the bitrate and hitching problems I had with AirLink were not there, knock on wood, but I did still have to increase the encode resolution width and set link sharpening to normal to get the visuals looking good. Virtual Desktop doesn't seem to have any of these same issues, as I simply set the settings in Virtual Desktop to what I wanted and the visuals were great. I don't know why this is, but for me, Virtual Desktop always stutters a bit. Even with my Nvidia GPUs. AirLink will work flawless for me, but Virtual Desktop will have at least a little bit of jitter. It wasn't horrible as I did all the testing for this video, but it was a little bit worse than what I saw with AirLink. Games were still playable, but there was more jitter and hitches overall with Virtual Desktop. I know there are some people out there that swear by Virtual Desktop, that it works way better for them than AirLink does, and I don't doubt that. I don't know why it's always a little jittery for me, but it is, and since that's what I experience with it, I have to let you guys know. Oh, I almost forgot. There was one other issue I ran into that was only present on Radeon 7000 GPUs and only happened when using AirLink. I ran into this issue before when reviewing the 7900 XTX, but I found a simpler solution than I offered in that video. The problem I'm referring to is some warping or squeezing that takes place on the far right side of your field of view. It's very weird and off-putting, and if you've experienced it, you know what I'm talking about. There's a couple ways I've found to fix it. The first and easiest way is to change the settings like I showed at the beginning of this video. After changing the encode resolution width and restarting the Oculus software, this right eye warping issue goes away. Now I should warn you that it only goes away temporarily. After several restarts of the Oculus app, it does come back, and when it does, you'll need to change the settings again in the Oculus Debug Tool and restart the Oculus software, or the other way to temporarily get rid of it, which is a bit more involved, is to first open Task Manager in Windows, scroll down to the Oculus Processes, and end each one of them. You'll now want to open Windows Explorer. Go to your C drive, Users, your name, app data. Now the app data folder is a hidden folder. So in order to see it, you'll want to click on view up here at the top and make sure this box for hidden items is checked. So in the app data folder, you want to click on roaming, Oculus, sessions, then this folder with a bunch of numbers, and you'll see three data.sqlite files in here. Delete all three of them. Now when you start the Oculus app and launch AirLink, the right eye squeezing will be gone. If you try to delete these files and get this message, it just means you need to end those tasks in Task Manager first, and once you've done that, you'll be able to delete these files without a problem. While I try to be optimistic, with as long as these problems have existed and continue to persist, it doesn't look like Meta is in any hurry to fix any of these issues, which I find disappointing because Radeon GPUs aren't as bad as many people believe. They're just as capable as their competition, but get a bad rep because many devs tend to prioritize Nvidia, making Radeon GPUs look worse than they actually are. Sure, it would be nice if VR worked right out of the box like it does with Nvidia GPUs, but I guess we should at least be grateful we have the tools available to us to make things look better than what Meta is giving us by default. Subscribe!